What is going on, guys? My name is Dimitri and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today, I'm gonna talk about an app that's not Notion, but it's good, and it's kinda like Notion, but it's not. And I figured I'd talk about it because I'm Notion guy, and anything that's close to it, I have to compare and be like, oh, is this thing like Notion? Is it good? Do you like it? I like it. It's a thing. Let's watch. While it doesn't have any databases, this application doesn't want to be anything else but a great note-taking app, and then we'll get into how it's actually got a nice extension functionality that can take it to the next level if you're interested, without bloating the baseline of the software. So going first into the example of what these different pages can do, we can see that it has markdown functionality just like anything else in this space. We can do a backslash here, and you can see that there are different text styles that you have with things like subtitles, titles. So this could also be a H1. It's the same thing as a title, and then H2 is a subtitle, H3 is a headline. So this is an example, and as can be seen on this, if we go under it, we can do different shortcuts that are similar to Notion, where it'd be like brackets make a checkbox, or you can do /2 or /toggle. And then there are obviously different things like font changing, but it's nice to have it within specific blocks. So as you can see, I can do a /font change. So it could be different for different blocks, which is not the same with Notion. And interestingly enough, I grab multiple of these blocks and I press Control G, you can group different blocks together. And you can see some of these action options by going to this spot right here, and pressing Control Shift G for this would ungroup it. But if I press Control G again, you can see you can actually click into this and it'll become its own little page here. Now you could make another page inside of a page just like you could in Notion, but that's different because it gives you the option to do it from just a grouping different blocks together to make it. Now I could take a bunch of text here. Due to the fact that this is a web application and that I don't have the opportunity to do something like right click on it, I have to rely on shortcuts because this is usually based for Mac. And it doesn't have a Windows version yet, but this web version works pretty well. And then just like in Notion, you can double click on any of this and it would change it, but you don't have that same functionality pressing this. This is just the dragging of the blocks here, but double clicking on this, you can do things like add the hyperlinks, do an at to something else in here. So adding it to another page, Control King it to a specific page as well, or a specific link as well, and then bolding it, coloring it differently and whatnot. If we do something like this, we could actually change the color by doing /green, changes it just like it would in Notion as well. And you have the option on the right here to do a couple more things. You can insert different tables by doing this drop down here. You can insert shortcuts before or after the selection, insert code snippets, lines, as well as look at the page details and change all of the fonts to a different font, show the cover image at the top of the page, and then just show the basic page info and see when it was created and when it was last updated. And looking at the bottom left here, you can see that there's a calendar to showcase all of your different notes in a timeline and calendar form view, which I actually am really intrigued by because Notion doesn't really have that level of calendar functionality with your notes. This is more of a note-taking app, and then it is a database app with tasks and whatnot. Now it can have basic tasks and it can do things in a different sort of colorful view than Notion can with things like cards, but it is not exactly the same as Notion in any sense of what it does on a functional level. It is specifically catered towards note-taking with a little bit of a twist on it, and not focusing on trying to do everything and having like timeline databases and all these different database functionalities overall. They have recently added Craft for Teams, and they've also added something in the last year which is very intriguing to many, which I'll get into really quick. If we go to learn more about CraftX, we can see there's a Craft Extensions developer platform, and people are going onto the platform and developing their own extensions so that the software itself doesn't get bloated, but people can do different things to actually add things to the product itself. There are examples on other videos that people have showcased where they have actually exported these different crafts pages to their blogs on things like Ghost, or sent it to different things to apps like Things 3 or Bear. And it is actually really good for the Mac ecosystem in general. So I would definitely check that out if you're a Mac user. The Craft extensions that are out there are very nice. So after the extensions, we can look at a couple interesting quick views here. So if we go to the right, there is a nice little sidebar that can pop up that showcases the different things that you can have regarding groups, as well as different changes to the functionality of what you have. So you can change the different decoration of what blocks look like by changing this stuff here from focus to block. And it looks like a call out in this sense. And then you can untoggle things like this. And rather than working with the markdown functionality, you can work with something like this if that's what you're more comfortable with. And then you could also take multiple things here and turn it into something like a card really easily, where you can add this and apply the style to it. And this card functionality is just a subsection of what a page is. So this is just a page functionality that is in a different type of view, and you can do any sort of note taking that you would want in here. And then if you want to utilize the sharing functionality of Craft, you can go to the little share and publish button here. Something nice about this is that it's similar to something like a Google Docs link, where you could share it to people who have this link only, and those people can view this rather than it being public domain. And then you could also easily export this to PDF. So I actually just press this right here. And if I press download PDF, you can see that quickly I will have a nicely exported PDF that has everything within it. And then it has different options for things like text bundle and markdown as well. Another nice thing to mention really quickly is that you can make folders. So if I had an example folder created here, I could go and choose the different icon that I would want for it, press select. And then on the web app, what I could do is I can go into all of my documents here, and I could, I mean, obviously beforehand go, and if I'm making a different page, and then I could add these different pages that I have by moving them to example folder created. And as can be seen in here, there is an example how to use Craft one within it. Now you can actually add a subfolder to this subfolder example, and this could have an icon itself. And then what I would actually do is I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna move it. And what you can do is you can move it to the subfolder in there as well. So as now can be seen, this has a little higher level of organization between the documents itself. So you can have things segmented out by not only just what is in the folder itself, but what is in the subfolders individually. Now I will say that there are keyboard shortcut functionalities that are nice within the actual application itself. However, I cannot showcase them because of the limitations that are coming from my side of things due to the fact that I am working on the web app, which doesn't have all these nice things. Like there is a spotlight functionality that's cool, where I could do something quick, like have different command buttons mixed in with what's going on here. But unfortunately, I can't do a crazy amount of things similar to what can happen in Craft on the Mac app.
If you like this video, make sure to check out this one to see how you can improve your productivity even more.